To all the little girls who are watching this, never doubt that you are valuable and powerful and deserving of every chance and opportunity in the world to pursue and achieve your own dreams.
I sat on the side of the pool and watched as Leah Thomas won, beating out Olympians, beating out American record holders, the most impressive female swimmers this country has ever seen by body lengths.
This bill says if you're a biological male, you cannot participate against biological females. It's as simple as that.
No group of kids should be banned from school sports, period. We all know what school sports are about. It's about teamwork, determination, physical well-being.
Trans kids are all God's children, belong in sports, in schools, in books, in families, and on teams.
And despite what some of my colleagues have falsely claimed, trans girls and women do not have an overwhelming physical advantage compared to others.
This isn't about protecting sports.
Out of all the issues in the world, House Republicans decided that on our very first day back, our very first bill would be a trans bullying bill. I mean, give me a break. Is this some kind of sick joke? What's next? A bill about who can play together during recess?
Because the idea that government would come along and tell people that in schools we're going to examine you and your reproductive anatomy in order to not, you're a female, is just insane.
So that's what we're debating here today. Whether or not young kids should have to get their genitals inspected or else they get kicked off the swim team. It's creepy.
There's this creepy idea, I guess this bill is going to require genital inspections of children. I mean, this is outrageous.
Just like all athletes, sometimes trans athletes win and sometimes they lose.
That next day, I raced Thomas in the 200 freestyle, which ended up in a tie.
Well, it's a sad day in Congress. I just got off the floor voting against what really is a weaponization of Title IX.
Having only one trophy, the NCAA gave it to Thomas and told me that I had to go home empty-handed because Thomas needed to hold the trophy for pictures.
School sports are supposed to promote inclusion, are supposed to support student well-being.
I felt betrayed and belittled, and like my efforts and sacrifices I had made had been reduced to a photo op to validate the identity and feelings of a male. But my feelings did not matter.
When in doubt, I always try to err on the side of kindness, mercy, and compassion.
In addition to being forced to give up our awards and our titles and our opportunities, the NCAA forced female swimmers to share a locker room with Thomas.
And don't accept this phony claim that this is about the safety of kids.
A 6'4", 22-year-old male equipped with and exposing male genitalia in a room full of vulnerable, undressed women.
Let them be who they are.
Let me be clear. We were not forewarned about this arrangement. No one asked for our consent, and we did not give our consent.
Please, err on the side of compassion, kindness. Let them live.
In 1972, Congress enacted Title IX to end unjust sex discrimination in all aspects of education, including collegiate athletics. Well, she was
an American. They're not bothering you.
Make no mistake about it. By allowing Thomas to displace female athletes in the pool and on the podium,
they're not taking your lunch money.
The NCAA and these colleges intentionally discriminated on the basis of sex.
Society has no room for HR 734 going forward.